Hello guys, welcome to another 2JZ Tuesday. Have you ever wondered how to increase my 2JZ horsepower into maybe around 500 horsepower? It is extremely easy, and I'm going to show to you guys. Coming up. So you have done your planning. What are the goals that is for your car? You want it to do normal street driving or drifting or drag? So all this you have already set beforehand. For example, if you want to go for street driving, you just need slightly higher horsepower and within your country's regulation, okay, maybe around 400-500 horsepower, and you have already upgraded your brakes and your suspension and your tires already, so it is sufficiently enough to stop you even if you are accelerating very fast, then okay, go for it. Okay, but if you're going for drifting, then you want very responsive engine, very low laggy turbo and stuff like that. Okay, and if you want to go for drag, of course you want to go as much horsepower as you can, but it also depends on how much traction you can put it onto the ground. For example, your tires and your suspension setting, if you're going for super high horsepower, then you need to have super good traction, and with super good traction you need a stronger sturdy materials for all your drivetrain, long shaft, transmission and drive shaft, everything. So today I'm going to show to you guys is my 500 horsepower drift application. Okay, what we want is very responsive engine, not so high horsepower, okay, suitable for the track, because our track here in Sabah is only quite small, second to third gear. So we just want a very responsive engine to overcome tandem, because a tandem, when the cars in front of us become slow, we can manage to follow them by adjusting our car. But if the car is too laggy, then we have to play too much with the clutch and make us more stressful and less fun, you see. So I hope I can share with you guys things that I've learned, and hope you guys learn something from this setup. And post below your comments on how is your car setup. Let me know. Okay, here is my setup. Okay, this one I purposely make it not so high horsepower, 500 horsepower, just nice for our tracks. And I made it very reliable. The temperatures of the water and oil temp all has been kept down, so that it can last longer during competitions, because we may need to fight quite far from a lot of one more time, a lot of practices, a lot of tandem practices, right? So we want to make it as reliable as we can. Come nearer, I'm gonna show you. Okay, so this one is my 2JZ on a Nissan Silvia 180SX chassis. So I'm gonna show you guys more of the stuffs that made it increase into 500 horsepower easily. 2JZ GE or GTE block, GE or GTE crankshaft, but the 2JZ GTE piston and conrod is a must for the bottom. Okay, 2JZ GTE oil pump too. Okay, and then the cylinder head, this one I purposely use the 2JZ GTE, because that one we can easily source the exhaust manifold, and the intake manifold I'm going to reuse it. Okay, so things that we need to include for our 500 horsepower target is a turbo. Okay, I purposely choose a super small sizing turbo exhaust housing, so that I can get a very responsive turbo. And then we need to include the banana, or we call it the exhaust manifold. Then we need fuel rail, injectors, cams. I'm just using the 265 intake and exhaust, non-BVTI, and an engine management. Okay, definitely you need to include the wastegate and also the blow-off tool. Okay, the ECU that I'm using is EMU Black. So I'm using this one. Okay, so I'm going to share with you guys some of the more important stuff which are cooling. Okay, so I got intercooler here. This one is quite a little bit dirty, but this one is a 3-inch thick intercooler. Okay, and then I got this oil cooler. And then radiator, I've choose to go to behind. So the radiator, I've already moved to the back, but it is not necessary. Some people just maintain it in the front, but definitely you need to use a new aluminium radiator, because the new one inside doesn't clog up that much. And the aluminium radiator, right, the top part and the bottom part, they are not plastics, so they can last longer. And also this one is quite thick, so this one can allow more coolant staying here and more cooling go when it is when the air goes through here. Okay, water pump I'm reusing back, and then even the aircon I'm using it, because currently I'm using Perspex. Perspex windows, so I cannot wind down the window, so it is very hot inside. So I definitely need the aircon, because it is very hot for two reasons. One is the temperature in Malaysia is very hot. Second one is it's because of to defogging when there is rain. So when there is rain, all the windshield, all will fog up. So we need to defog it by cooling down inside or letting outside air to come in. Since I cannot wind down the window, so I have to cool down the air inside. Okay, which is another plus too. Since raining, the engine temperature won't go up that much too. Okay, so for drift application, I use this surge tank. But if for street application, you don't need to have a surge tank. So what does a surge tank do is basically this one is your fuel tank. It has fuel, but it is slushing here and there, especially when we are cornering left and right. It's just using a normal fuel pump just to transfer it to here. But this one is using an uprated fuel pump. For now, I'm using a DW300. I'm going to insert a link down in the description where they buy it. And this fuel pump is going to supply a very healthy fuel pressure of about up to 60 psi. Depends on how much boost I have. The fuel regulator is going to help me to adjust it. Alright, so what does this surge tank do is it fills up the fuel, and then after it is full, then it will return back to your fuel tank. So this surge tank is always full. So it doesn't matter whether I accelerate very fast or decelerate or left or right. Okay, depending on how much boost you are running. If you are running high boost, then you may need uprated cooling. But definitely you can do try and error first. So that means you can install your turbo. After that, then you have started your engine, you have dynoed your car. Then you can try to let it run and see during high boost, your water temperature will it go up. Okay? Okay, don't forget to use this oil filter that plugs in the water coolant too, because this way the water will cool down your engine oil and make it roughly the same. If not, you'll be having issues with your oil temp getting too high. Okay guys, hope you guys learned something. Comment below if you guys got any question regarding build, especially for horsepower below 500 horsepower of a 2JZ. I'm going to answer them as fast as I can. And then I'm going to build another 2JZ, but this one I'm still you know, saving for funds, looking for sponsors to build the first 2JZ 1000 horsepower in Sabah. Although it is, it is fairly simple in other countries, but in Sabah the technology is not that advanced yet. But I certainly hope that more and more people is going to appreciate the knowledge of engine building. I certainly hope that more and more people is going to appreciate the knowledge behind the engine building and also apply all your mechanical skills into what we love. This is what I believe in. Okay, stay tuned as I'm building one simple engine blueprint book just for you guys. Okay, stay tuned. See you.